Hi everyone, my name is Jenny and I treat myself with a fecal microbiota transplantation, or FMT, to overcome my irritable bowel syndrome, IBS, and my chronic fatigue. Keep in mind, I'm neither a doctor nor a naturopath. If you are considering trying an FMT, discuss it with your doctor and never use an unscreened donor. When I first heard about fecal microbiota transplantation, I found a very interesting study by Professor Magdi El-Sali in 2019. In this study, all test subjects had been struggling with IBS. Some of the test subjects got an FMT from a special donor. The others got a placebo FMT containing their own stool. After 3 months, 90% of the test subjects who got an FMT from the special donor experienced significant improvements, and almost 50% of them were completely cured. I think this is an amazing study because it shows that with FMT it is possible to relieve IBS and to rebalance the gut microbiome. The special feature of this study is not only the great result, it is the donor. Professor El-Sali calls this donor a super donor, and he explains what makes him a super donor. This donor was a 36-year-old man, non-smoker, born naturally and breastfed, who ate a healthy diet, had a very low use of antibiotics or medicines, and who was very athletic. If you want to take a deeper look at this study, you can find the link in the description of this video. Now, let's focus on the criteria for a super donor that I mentioned and how to find one. One of the most important criteria of a super donor is his birth. When a baby is born naturally, during its birth, it comes into contact with its mother's microbiome. A C-section may perturb the early establishment and development of the gut microbiome. That's why it is essential that your donor was born naturally, not by C-section. Additionally, your donor should have been breastfed for several months, around 6 months up to 1 year. Mother's milk contains a lot of lactic acid bacteria and bifidobacteria that are very important for health. It also contains galacto-oligosaccharides. It's a prebiotic that feeds good gut bacteria. So being naturally born and breastfed for a long period increases the diversity of a gut microbiome. Another criteria of a super donor is his use of antibiotics and medicines in general. Every time we take an antibiotic, we kill some bacteria in our gut and reduce our diversity of gut bacteria. Ideally, your donor should have taken zero antibiotics in his lifetime. In addition, your donor should not take any drugs because they can also have an effect on gut permeability. Diet especially plays a huge role regarding the gut microbiome. Your donor should follow a diet which is rich in nutrients. He should avoid fast food and processed food, but focus on fresh organic vegetables and fruits and high quality meat and fish. The best diets for a healthy gut microbiome are a paleo diet and a Mediterranean diet. Furthermore, being athletic is connected to a diverse gut microbiome. The best age for being a super donor is under 30, because your microbiome changes the older you get. So if you're looking for a super donor, focus on young, athletic, slim people. With an FMT, you do not only get some gut bacteria, an FMT can also result in a transmission of communicable diseases. That's why you must make sure that your donor does not have any kind of illness. A super donor does not have any diseases or conditions like allergies, such as hay fever, gut issues like bloating, constipation, diarrhea or food intolerances, thyroid problems, neurological issues, depression, acne or dermatitis. Absolutely none of them. A super donor is super healthy and has a very strong immune system. Last but not least, the most important criteria of a super donor is daily perfect stool. You can check your donor stool type with the Pristol scale. Daily perfect stool is only type 3 on the Pristol scale, with no exceptions. Ask your potential donor to send you some photos of his stool for a few days. You can check them with the Pristol scale. You can find the link to the Pristol scale in the description. To find your own super donor, make some flyers with a short summary of the criteria of a super donor, add your email or your phone number, and share these flyers in gyms, sport universities, or other places for young athletic people. Now I wish you good luck in finding your own super donor. If you have questions or any wishes for some other topics, please write it down in the comments.